Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of the Some Ordinary Podcast. It's me, your host, Mudahar, and I've got your co-host, Caleb, also known as Oompaville, and I've got Nux Taku. And, of course, as always, we've got Solid JJ over here, who's not doing a face reveal. We've seen his face. We've seen everything. But you will not, ladies and gentlemen.
He's beautiful.
Very, very beautiful. So beautiful, we have to put the meme text on top of it, okay?
Classic. Epic.
So, that sounds so derogative. That sounds so fun. Ladies and gentlemen.
You guys like Grumpy Cat?
Oh, absolutely. But we want to kind of talk about like some of the stuff that's happened over on YouTube. Not really. There's not really a lot of things that have happened. It's kind of been, I would say, really depressing news on top of really depressing news. I think signing on to social media is like one of the worst decisions you can make in like the last 48, 72 hours, or really since the start of, I guess, this conflict. But in YouTuber stuff, you know, Sniper Wolf finally got her court, you know, in punishment by YouTube. How do we all feel about that shit, by the way? Do we feel that it's enough? Do we feel that she's been punished?
I wouldn't say so, but also, where's Jack been?
I think Jack has been in hiding, I think.
I'm worried he actually is trying to move because he's afraid, like, of being in a house that was exposed to all these people. Like,
I agree.
I get it. He's traumatized. When's the last time you insulted someone and they just showed up to your house?
My mom. I can say... Actually, I can't even say this for Caleb because you've made fun of so many people and you've invited them to your own house, so it's not even applicable to you.
That's a good point. That's a really... I didn't even think about that.
Oh my god, like, dude.
I'm kind of known for that.
You skipped that whole phase over. You didn't give him a chance to show up involuntarily. You're like, just come on over.
Just come on over, dude. Let's hang out.
But like, okay, but actually, there's a good point to that, too. Do you ever feel like when you do that, you're like, you feel unsafe?
No.
He has enough guns.
No. Well, I mean, I don't feel unsafe. I don't think, it takes a lot to make me feel unsafe.
Like what, I don't want to, like, ask you if it's like, what would unsettle the Oompaville radar then?
If I'm in my home and I have, like, people around me, then it's very little that would make me feel unsafe. Like, actually, people would have to be, like, stalking me actively or, like, at my front door with a negative intention.
Right.
Yeah. I don't know. I just don't. I mean, I don't really think about that kind of stuff. So, yeah. I don't know. It would be a lot, to be honest. It would take a lot.
You don't think about that, but you think about dying in like August and shit.
Oh, that's a prophecy, though. That's funny.
That's a prophecy. What about you? What about you, JJ? What do you think? What would you do if you were criticizing some Andy on the internet and they just popped up in front of your like front door, like you summoned them out like the Ring?
If they appeared. Well, I don't think it's bad intention, good intention. If anyone shows up, I'm probably gonna be hiding in my like Cloverfield bunker that I have.
You got a Cloverfield bunker?
Yeah, I got Cloverfield. I even got a what's his name from in that movie? What's that big guy? Super skinny.
Cloverfield?
Man. No, the second one, the one that has like the fucking big guy.
You were
yeah,
expecting...
I got John Goodman. I got him stuck down there.
You got John.
This guy's got his own name, John Goodman.
All right. I mean, like, hey, listen.
All right.
If somebody showed up to your... If somebody tracked you down, because here's the thing about Nox, his identity is only known by the U.S. government and the IRS. Other than that, no one knows who the fuck Nox is. What would you do if somebody showed up? I'd be so scared if somebody was able to track your ass down.
I
know the effort you take to hide your identity.
It would scare the crap out of me. Like, to be honest. I am not easily unsettled, but when I'm, like, surprised, that just makes it... I lose mm-hmm. composure for sure.
Well,
very little surprises me, but if it does surprise me, I will flip out.
Well, speaking of like surprises, I don't know if you caught like Jack's like stream. Like, I just saw it like before we started filming here when he was like in the middle of live streaming and she shows up and he's like, "What the fuck? She's outside the house?"
I saw that.
Oh hell, that one, like that clip resonated pretty goddamn hard with me because the only time I've ever like actually been like threatened over on YouTube by somebody that had the ability to come over to my house was probably JStation, where like he sent me a DM that he was gonna knock my fucking teeth out or some crazy shit like that. But even then, like, I wasn't really that scared. I'm like, whatever, it's like JStation, okay? He shows up, it's like a fucking, it's like a crackhead adventure 342 in my book. But like,
so, after my like big doxing drama with like V Shoujo years ago, I'm sure you remember this, Solid JJ, you probably never heard of this and you are better off. I actually was messaged by one of the cybersecurity people at VShoujo saying that they picked up a lot of, like, chatter that they are trying to dox me and actively swap me right now. They're just doing their due diligence by letting me know. And that scared the crap out of me, because I wasn't even home. I wasn't home. So, like, I mean, called, like, the police. I told them, listen, I'm just a YouTuber. I'm just a guy being funny on the internet. People don't like me. Listen, don't worry.
Well, it's crazy how much, like, information you can pull out on somebody. Like, you guys know the channel Barely Sociable? Like, you guys know him, Hunter?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. He is, like, without a doubt, one of the most, like, fucking elite OSINT dudes that I ever know. Like, if you ever want to find somebody who's hidden in, like, the ass end of the world, he can probably find you. He was, like, one of the chief guys that helped me find one of the... Me and Coffee find one of the people behind the Rubet shit that was, like, so hidden. Like, we're talking... Barely Sociable was able to help us find this dude who was hidden behind, like, one dead forum, cached under another dead forum, and then, like, one other dead forum from 10 years ago. So it's like, if you ever have posted, like, anything personal on the internet, like, at all, like, you hire a decent private investigator, you'll find anybody. Like, you're never truly anonymous on the internet, which I guess is the shittiest part, especially when you're in, like, that creator space, right? And to kind of whittle it all back down to, like, Jack, too, you know, he criticized Sniper Wolf, and I don't even think, like, criticism is okay. Like, criticism in the sense that I don't even think he was malicious. Like, I don't know if... Nobody can call what he did malicious. He spent most of his time crediting actual authors and artists and, you know, played bingo with her shit-tier content.
He was obviously making fun of her, but making fun of people is not illegal.
Not in the eyes of YouTube, though. They said that... Didn't they say, like, they didn't the behavior on either side?
I saw that.
Oh, of course. They didn't like... And that's the weirdest part about it, too, because I know, like... Caleb, you were pretty critical of that, like, statement that YouTube made, too, because I know, I'll just say it for myself, I make a lot of content that is critical of, like, you know, shitty creators, and I don't think the content that I make is necessarily harmful, or at least I don't go, like, below the belt, and I know Caleb doesn't either, so I don't understand what YouTube went with, like, we don't like the argument on both sides if you're being critical of somebody for actual malfeasance, you know?
It's like it's a personal thing. It's like they're personally friends with... It was not professional at all. It was weird.
Yeah. I felt when I read the both sides thing, it was almost like, if there's some blame on Jack, well, then that means we don't need to punish Sniper Wolf that badly.
Yeah.
Right? Like it's almost like he incited her into doing something, which I don't think was the case. But if YouTube blames him somewhat, then, you know, you're not going to ban Sniper Wolf if it's both sides.
It's like there's tons of creators like we'll shit on because they're just stupid fucking creators. Like this one recently, this guy came up. Japan is like huge right now for I guess live streamers and traveling there. Dude, beyond Johnny Somali, I just found out about today. Literally, that like there was another guy.
No, it's not the guy that traveled across Japan for free. That guy
traveled across Japan for free. Yeah, it's him. Like, dog.
That guy's awesome.
It's so insane. Like, all right, listen. Committing crimes is one thing.
Wait, Solid JJ, do you know about this guy?
What guy?
So this is the same guy. He made a video like a year ago, visiting poor people in Africa, and the thumbnail is just him in the center with like a bunch of like African children around him just like crying, and he's in the center like with the shocked thumbnail face. Like,
wait.
What? These people are poor? Right? Like that was his video. And
I did not know that was the same guy.
No. Yeah, either.
I'm pretty sure that's the same guy. And so he just made another video traveling across Japan from free, filming himself doing a whole like array of crimes.
Oh,
that is the guy.
That. Yeah,
it's the same guy.
Just film himself.
Phineas!
Hiding in trains and shit. And then he's like, "What? Why is it with meth?"
Yeah. He's like, "Oh no, the police are after me. I'm gonna run away now." Yeah, sure.
All right, here it is. Phidias Panayo. Oh, Jesus, guy's last name is worse than mine. What the f? Let me screen share this real quick. Phidias Panayoto.
Damn.
All right, I really hope I pronounced that one right. Oof. YouTuber apologizes for fare dodging, begging, and eating without paying in Japan.
And you know what his response? His response is fire, though, because when I saw his response. Damn. I remember him saying that I should have looked into the Japan's culture before doing that. It's like, what culture? Do you need, you need to look into the culture before realizing you can't rob people there? Like,
yeah, right. I needed to look into the culture to see if I have to pay the bill or not. Wait, Phidias posted a video titled "I Traveled Across Japan for Free on 20th October," which featured him and three others competing in a race across the country for $10,000. Dude, this guy Mr. Beasted a crime. That's so insane.
Yep, and he got three other YouTubers to also Mr. Beast the same crime.
That's so crazy, like, being stupid yourself and then finding three other idiots to do that with you. The YouTuber has 2.4 million subscribers, filmed himself riding on Japan's PTS, and claimed he did so without paying. In the since-removed video, he's been detained at a police station after he told officers he didn't have enough money to pay for the bus fare. The stranger earlier gave him 600 yen, and he was still short of the full fare. According to Japanese laws, begging is not allowed in the Damn!
Damn!
I did not know that.
It's illegal to be poor out there.
Damn!
Holy crap. Streamer economy is dying, that's for sure.
That's so crazy. That's like, that's how you stop homelessness. Just make it fucking illegal, dude. What the
Ace and red pill, bro.
Dude, I did not know begging was illegal in Japan. That's fucking crazy. But yeah, he wants to apologize to Japanese people. And I guess that's fine and dandy.
Should have researched the culture better.
Poor guy. So what I understand, he's just being, like, fined, I guess. Like, they're not going to put him into jail, right? Like, that's not... He's not going to prison over this. And I really don't think he should be going to prison over this. But at the same time, like, can YouTubers, like, foreign people stop making, like, us look bad in Japan's eyes? Because it makes traveling just that much more annoying. Eventually, they got to crack down on stupid shit like this, you know?
I was going to say, like, the last story I remember hearing was that one guy going around just harassing people and, like, sneaking into construction sites and shit.
Oh, Johnny Somali? Oh, man. You're coming across two goddamn experts in that field right now. Please ask us AMA, dude. I know all about Johnny Somali now.
Yeah, I want to know about him. His name is so interesting.
Dude, Johnny Somali is... So last night I saw this, like... I think it was Aiden Ross's, like, misinformation pool, who was like, Johnny Somali got 5 years in, like, prison or something. First off, I was like, okay, as f***ed up as Johnny Somali is, I still think 5 years is kind of a lot for what he did, you know? At least in my opinion. I think 5 years in prison is a f*** ton of time for... irregardless of whatever that idiot did. I do think some prison time is warranted. Five just seems like a lot.
Nah.
There was... Huh?
Nah, that's plenty.
You think 5 years in the most strict Japanese prison... Okay.
I think life.
He would...
just to take him out back.
Is stoning still a thing? Do you honestly think he's going to learn from that?
Is stoning still illegal?
He's going to just get out and do the same shit.
Do you really think after 5 years of being, like, in the most, like, intense Japanese prisons, like, where he has to follow rules all the time, he's gonna come out being, like, a total douchebag? You think he won't actually learn anything?
No, I don't think so, no.
We need to put him in, like, the old boy program.
What's the old boy program?
From the movie, the fucking old boy, we'll just put him in that situation. I think he comes out of that a better man.
Yeah. Just make him
explain
start digging
the old
holes.
Boy program.
Just make him dig holes. Just give him a shovel.
You ever see the movie Old Boy?
No.
Really? Okay, so... This is going to be an interesting story. Guy is like a drunkard in Japan, gets arrested.
I've seen this, yeah.
He made some decisions in his life that end up catching up with him. He breaks out of this prison thing. Has to like fight. This is a very... I think I take back this joke. This is going a bit darker than I thought.
No, you gotta
Google
ending now, buddy.
Google ending of Old Boy. And
that's the movie with the dude who beats like 30 people up with a hammer.
Yep, that's the movie.
I've seen it before.
Oh, I've seen. I just looked up Old Boy. I had noticed this actor, like the one dude.
In the end of the movie Old Boy, Woo Jin kills himself, and Dai Su is left with the pain of incest. What does that
Spoiler
mean?
Alert.
This joke
wait,
would
hold
make
on,
so much
more.
You
gotta explain your joke a little better. What the? Wait.
No, hold on. Listen, I'm not going down for this Johnny Somali joke. He sounds like a background character, Sopranos. I'm not.
Oh my god, I'm just reading this. However, he visits the hypnotist from earlier and asks her to make him forget everything. In the epilogue, Dai Su meets Woo Jin's hypnotist and requests her to wipe his memory of his incestuous relationship, to which she acquiesces. Alternatively, after sparing Dai Su's life, Woo Jin steps into his personal elevator, pulls a- Oh my god.
Dude, I gotta watch this fucking movie. Okay. Holy shit. This is like three goddamn feature-packed horrors and like thrillers in one. My god. But I don't think. Listen, you know, I'm gonna have to disagree with Caleb, my co-host here on the life imprisonment. I think he can.
That was
learn.
A dip.
I, Well, listen. even if it wasn't a joke, part of me does kind of agree with you because you are right. Like, streamers don't actually learn, right? Like, that's the problem.
If he becomes a streamer at the end, it will be a recidivism. He probably won't do it in Japan anymore. Yeah.
He might do it in another country, but like the thing about it is, he's one of those guys where I don't know if like. We had this discussion a week ago where we talked about like Arabandi, and it's like when they do the crime and they come out and they're like kind of when they reformed, like they can be good people in the eyes. I feel like he could have that opportunity. He goes to prison, he comes out, doesn't do this shit again, and he becomes a regular normal streamer. That might turn things around. But for now, it's like the platform that he's on. He kind of just like, I guess he's just goaded into doing this stupid shit until he just will end up getting arrested again, you know? It's just...
I don't know. I feel like it's Ice Poseidon again. Do you remember when Ice Poseidon was banned on Twitch the first time, and he spent the next few years, like, trying to be clean to get unbanned on Twitch? He's way worse now than he ever was on Twitch.
Well, I mean, right? That's because he's on Kick now, and Kick doesn't give a shit. You could.
But Johnny Somali's gonna get out of prison, and he's gonna be on Kick. Like...
I guess.
If you look at FoozyTube, okay? This man, he'll do something insane, and then he'll, like, lie low for 2 years, and then he'll come back and he'll do something even crazier. Like, I don't think a punishment, like, rehabilitates these people, per se. But also, five years in prison is a long time for... I mean, he just disturbed the peace, right? He didn't actually hurt anybody. Like, yeah, he was a menace to society.
He did multiple charges. Right? Trespassing, multiple charges, jumping into, like, construction sites, causing harm to people. Mm-hmm. I mean, potential harm, I guess, to people. So, that's the stuff he was... And also, like, you gotta understand, Japan is one of those countries where it's not innocent until proven guilty. It's very much, you're f***ing guilty until you somehow prove yourself innocent, so...
Yeah, Japan is... It's not like one of those random find-out countries.
No. And that's one of the things, too. It's like, dude, if you're going to go to another country and be a dumbass like that, and then you're going to get busted, you can't expect sympathy from people, right? It's like fucking going to Saudi Arabia and, like, preaching fucking, you know, like, all your values and then not getting your head chopped off. It's like, dude, there's only so much that anybody can do. It's like, you went to this country and willingly fucked yourself, you know?
Shout out to Mia Khalifa, who made a really banger tweet about,
dude,
like, the whole...
Dude, I swear to God that, like, so, I'm not a, like, okay... We're not geopolitical experts. Like, I would say our expertise... Can we go over our expertise? Like, what are we experts in? Okay, Nox, you start off with. What do you consider yourself an expert in?
I am an expert in memeing and internet degenerate shit. In other words, I am useless. I am not an important member to society. I am someone that spits at my computer all day. What do you do, Mudahar?
I program and also f***ing spit at my computer all day, too.
Caleb,
what about you?
Candy.
Caleb delivers diabetes straight to your f***ing doorstep.
Right to the bloodstream, dude.
Right into the fight. F***ing mainlines that shit. JJ, what do you consider yourself an expert in?
I actually have a bachelor's in international politics.
No! Bullshit. Don't say that!
Are you for real?
I got no f***ing clue.
Oh, thank God.
I can't even spell all that.
Well, okay. Like, so none of us are experts in the current, like, conflict that's going on. And, like, it's kind of weird how, like, celebrities have to, like, start taking, like, weird sides and get constantly involved without ever looking into, like, the actual situation. It's been a thing where, like, a bunch of celebrities, like Mia Khalifa, which I haven't heard of this name since the fucking Bang Bus days at all. So I don't even know, like, she existed anymore, but she came back with one of the stupidest takes. I feel like, Nux, you should describe this. You should, like, read this one out for us.
Oh, God. So, I'm not gonna read out the whole thing, but basically, it was a whole thing about...
You can't read out the whole thing. We'll get f***ing guidelines.
Yeah, I'll get murdered from the YouTube partner program. But basically, so this happened when the actual terrorist attack happened in Israel. Like, right when it started. And she basically says, like... you will be on the wrong side of history if you think that this wasn't justified. Something along those lines. Which is mind-blowing, right? And the responses are all like, you know, I don't take political advice from whores that are banned from their own country. Or like, you know, if you would try saying this there, you would get beheaded. You know, like, the responses, like, annihilated her.
Right.
Like, wild stuff. And then she kept tweeting. That's the craziest thing. She didn't stop. Mm-hmm. She had another one saying, can you tell the Hamas guys to flip their phones and film horizontally instead?
Bro, whoa. That was the most insane, that was what? The most Black like, Mirror shit that I've ever fucking seen in my life.
Is that real?
That is real.
Yeah, that's fucking, I saw that shit with my own eyes.
Holy me too. That's when I decided, yeah, I had enough Twitter.
Dude, there was so much insane shit that like I had to like fucking refresh the page, like scroll down a little bit and just like force the app to refresh. Cause I was like, excuse me, am I on the right app? Like, what? Am I on like 4chan or am I on like Twitter? I don't know what I'm on. So there was a lot of up shit.
Oh my
god. What is kind of insane though is like one guy that I feel really bad for is Ethan Klein. Like he's been the one guy that's just been like destroyed by his like own community at the moment too, or at least some people in his community. Not everyone, obviously, but there's like. I don't know if you guys noticed, but like he quit like X, or you know, eternally known as Twitter, I guess at this point, just because like I could imagine this shit's gotten so personal for him.
I'm sure it did. He was cannibalized by his own audience. Like, it's wild. It's wild that he didn't see this coming, and it's even wilder that Jordan Peterson predicted it like 2 years ago. Like, he made a whole tweet. Ethan Klein, you are a reasonable fellow. You will get cannibalized by the creation that you are creating. Mark my words. And everyone read that and was like, all right, Jordan Peterson, go back to the sobriety home or whatever. You know?
Dude, Jordan Peterson's a weird guy. Like, I always hate, like, kind of agreeing with him from time to time. But, like, sometimes he says some shit that really just holds up, you know?
No, I think he is an intelligent man. That's for sure.
Yeah, I think he just sounds like Kermit the Frog.
He does sound a little like
such a fucking asshole.
He does. It's true.
He's such a fucking asshole, dude.
Oh, what you do without men?
No, he's a dude. It's the whole internet like brain rot. It's funny because like it's everything so shifted onto the internet. Like it used to be, I guess, what our parents must have seen on like Fox and CNN and all that shit. Like you know, back when we were kids. But now it's all just translated over to the internet. Every King Pundit is now like a YouTuber, and now it's just, this is the shit that like clogs up the feeds now. It's hard to escape from it, as sad as it is, but
just as you mentioned earlier, none of us have like any knowledge of geopolitics that we feel like our opinion is actually worth anything in this scenario. If you want to actually learn about the geopolitical situation, go watch people that actually know what they're talking about. But every idiot with a microphone feels like they have to, you know, divulge their two cents about a really complicated situation.
Yeah.
And
like, I had one DM hit me. It's like, you should use your platform to spread this. I'm like, listen, dude, I know one thing in my life, okay? I know one topic by the back of my hand. Nikocado avocado, dude. I know that motherfucker like a champ. If it's anything to do with that, I'll discuss it. If it's anything to do with him 3 a.m. bullshit channel, I'll talk about anything to do with, like, f***ing computers and Linux, I'll talk about that. But this, I got no f***ing clue whatsoever. And
I feel like they fall into a similar category.
What, like Nikocado Avocado and, like, Palestine?
Yeah, Nikocado Avocado and, you know, Israel and Palestine, they're kind of like...
Yeah, I can see it.
Yeah, there's some cross-relation, I guess you could... there's some cross-branding, I guess. No, it's like, dude, it's like some people only know what they know, and that's pretty much what it comes down to. And there's just, like, no shame in that, too. I think it's just downright, like, weird when you start to see, like, celebrities, like, fucking... I was about to say Ellen DeGeneres, but I don't even think she said shit about this at all, so...
Probably not.
I don't know,
but, dude...
I don't know why she
showed up.
You know
even wilder than celebrities? The freaking basketball teams... Like, why do you need the Miami Heat to tweet, like, you know, anything
dude,
about this?
Exactly. It's like they're part of the UN or some shit. Like, the Dallas Cowboys have to
like,
offer
who are you?
Take.
You play basketball. You play with balls all day, okay?
Dude, that was probably some of the dumbest, like, wildest shit that I've ever seen. It's like the fucking, like, Dallas Cowboys, Miami Heats, or, like, the fucking Golden State Warriors have to, like, offer their two cents. I'm like, wait a minute. You guys are part of the NBA. Like, what the fuck? And, like,
what are your two cents?
Yeah, and it was so weird. It's like, I don't know, the whole situation is just insane. What really kind of pisses me off and what's keeping me away from, like, everything is just the amount of people who are using a conflict to, like, push their own narratives or whatever, right? Like, that's all it really comes down to. And I think what's really fucking insane about this is, like, the amount of misinformation and, like, fake information. Like, you know, it used to be, like, fake news was, like, a meme, right? Like, from the Trump days, it's like, oh, CNN fake news, right? And nowadays, it's like a lot of the news that you see is kind of fake. It's misrepresented. I mean, with how good AI and all this shit has gotten, it's like I don't even believe any call, any video, anything anymore. Like, unless I see it with my own eyes.
I know. It's actually terrifying. And also, like, forget just misinformation. It's this whole using other people's, catching them in lies and, like, unraveling their whole, like, argument, for example. I don't remember the whole back and forth, but 40 babies were killed, right? 40 Israeli, like, innocent babies were killed by, you know, mm-hmm. terrorists, basically. And I don't remember who it was that said that they were beheaded. Okay, and then there's this whole narrative of, show us the pictures. I didn't see any pictures of beheaded babies. Your whole story must be fake, right? And it's just, are you losing the forest for the trees here, sir?
That's like actually so fucking wild. Like, it reminds me of, and I think I might have talked about this with Charlie actually, but it's like, I remember when we were like talking about like, I remember like when allegations come up and it's like, oh, this person posted like CP on the platform, right? And like you criticize them for it. They were like, oh yeah, well, show us the photos. I'm like, yeah, I really can just show you illegal photos. Let me just broadcast the illegal f***ing photography just to show you guys, right? Like, Jesus Christ. It is insane. It's like, I don't know if you guys were, like, doing the AI stuff, like, years ago, like, when it started, like, a year ago, you know? But yeah. I remember, like, people were laughing at how infant, like, how like, you know, tiny it felt, how new it felt at the time. But, like, every month, every 2 months, there would be, like, a new development, you know? It's like we went from Will Smith eating spaghetti to now Quebelcop has decided to replace his entire personality with artificial intelligence. Is it good yet? No. But is it better than the Will Smith spaghetti eating days? Absolutely. And the thing is, for new shit, it's like, for information you find on the internet, dude, how are you supposed to believe anything, you know?
Right, it can all be fake. Voice calls could be fake. Actual images could be fake. Here, so I just saw this. Someone sent this to me. I put it in our chat. And I listened to it, and it blew my mind. I don't know if you actually want to share it, but it's...
it's the AI covers? Yeah, they're AI really covered, fucking good.
I could not believe this. Like, I first started listening to it. I'm like, wait, when did this happen? When did I sing this? And then I realized I never sang this, but it's me.
Because you can be gaslit into thinking you did something and you didn't, right? Like, Jesus Christ, you know? But I don't know what the answer to any of that shit is. Like, I think the world is getting to a point where, like, we've got so much information, and it's just now the information is so easily fake that it's like, now I'm at a point where unless I see shit with my own eyeballs, I don't believe it, you know? And it goes for, like, even YouTuber shit as well, too. It's like, if I don't see it, like, I notice every time some stuff happens and photos get posted, I'm always looking at hands, I'm always looking at tells of AI before I actually confirm shit, you know? Like, if I see horrific events happen, like a bombing, I'm always looking for, like, oh, where the AI is. I'm always looking for gaps in a matrix, you know?
One thing that I do believe, though, and this I have seen with my own eyes now, again and again, so I know for a fact it's true. If YouTube demonetizes you, even though they say that it doesn't hurt your view count, it does. And proof of that is Sniper Wolf's latest video, where now that she's demonetized, she only got 380,000 views in over a day.
How long do you think she's going to be demonetized for, guys?
A month.
It's probably monetized right now.
No, she, bro, come on now. Do you guys see what she was doing with, like, her other accounts when she got instantly demonetized?
Yeah, she's just reposting the same videos on other channels that are monetized. Oh,
which
my
is,
God.
It's so fucked up, because if any of us did that, I feel like our partner reps would be like, we're in trouble now because you just broke the guidelines and fucking circumvented your ban. That's what we would have gotten hit with. The fact that she was doing it was insane to me. And, like, she kind of has to know she's doing it because you've been a YouTuber for so long. You kind of know what you can and can't do. That was just a very sly way to get out of it. And that's what I loved about her apology. Because, like, we were talking about AI just now. Her apology felt like f***ing artificial intelligence. I don't know if she writes it, her team, a lawyer, YouTube, or f***ing ChatGPT, or a weird combination of all five. But, like... she wasn't actually apologetic about anything. She was right back to uploading her shitty TikTok reactions on another.
She didn't
page.
Even miss a beat. She crazy didn't that miss a beat.
Crazy, her apology went right, like, within minutes after YouTube made a comment.
Yeah, that was definitely, like, a team effort there.
Convenient.
Like,
timing,
we'll demonetize you for a month. You apologize, same time.
Yeah, it's like, dude, obviously we know that YouTube made you do the apology, but it's like, man, the weird nature of, like, YouTube being so involved in a creator and, like, being so ready to, like, protect them at a moment's notice is just, insane. It's like, I think Caleb, you were telling us, like, how many total like channel views did she get in 1 month alone? Like some insane 700 plus million?
750 million yeah. views in a month.
And it's lots. Like, if you think about it, it's like, dude, she's fucking like overlapping Mr. Beast and all these other people for YouTube. So of course they're going to be like in defense of her. But like, obviously I think the last week showed that YouTube very much plays favorites, and it's something we shout on Twitch for. But now YouTube pretty much has confirmed that, yeah, we'll play favorites if we have to. Sniper Wolf is definitely ours. And if you think about it, like, she's such a big creator that, like, in the grand scheme for YouTube, the vast majority still don't even know what happened, right? Like, that's pretty much what it is for YouTube. It's like, this is still very much relegated to the internet. Nobody really cares. But yeah, they kind of got away with it. She got a little slap on the wrist. And will she be back to re-uploading TikTok crap? Probably. I don't know how long like that'll make. Like, the thing is with YouTube is like, it kind of sucks because when you factor it in for YouTube, I think they're kind of okay with it because they kind of realize that if she downloads all the popular TikToks and everything, they just funnel all the viewership that would have gone to TikTok over right. to YouTube. So it's kind of like, oh, we don't even have to do anything, but like, we're kind of cannibalizing all of our competition in a way, too. That's the conspiracy that comes to my head. Not saying that YouTube's doing that. Maybe, you know. But it's insane, right? Like, you kind of think, you kind of connect the dots a little bit. You kind of see her real value over just her AdSense dollars, right?
And what's even scarier, and, like, this is almost, like, a sad way to look at it, but she showed up to Jax Films' house. She is still uploading content every day, the same slop, and Jax Films has not posted content. He might move. His second channel is completely dead right now. He got both sides to buy YouTube, so it looks like YouTube is going to maybe even take action if he continues. She won. She won the drama by doxing him.
Okay? I mean, that is like, a very...
It's almost like a dystopian way to look at it, but she almost won. It's like she was having Jax Film shit on her every day, and she was getting tons of hate, right? Fairly, in my opinion. And by doxing him, all that stops.
And it's like, you kind of wonder, it's like, what does that mean for, like, the rest of anybody, right? Like, the rest of us who are, like, I mean, I'm just going to say it for, like, me and Caleb, because I know we do make content that's critical of, like, some dumb people. Like, what does that mean for any of us going forward? It's like, is this just okay? Or are we in the wrong? Like, should we not be critical of anybody?
I feel like there's just no way they would ever do that.
No way that they wouldn't allow anybody to be critical?
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. I mean, I feel like, I don't know. I definitely think what Jack did is definitely a lot different than just normal. You know, because, I mean, he's, like, really... And it's a huge issue, but it's, like, also from YouTube's perspective where they don't see it as a huge issue, it just seems, like, closer to being unreasonable. It makes sense why they're... It's YouTube. I mean, they're not, like, creators. They're fucking... It's a platform. They don't care. Sniper Wolf makes them $1 billion.
But then... So you're saying they don't give a fuck about the community aspect of it, but, like...
No.
Do you think that the content that we make, like, where we're critical of other people, that's in, like, danger because YouTube doesn't want that?
I don't think so. I don't think so. Because I think they see that as a completely different thing from what Jack's done.
Mm-hmm. But what is the difference between what me and you have done versus, like, Jack? Is it just, like, the amount of content he's put on one person or the target that he put on?
Yeah, I think, I just think that the difference is from the perspective of YouTube. YouTube thinks that what she's doing is okay.
Mm-hmm.
YouTube doesn't care about EDP or, you know, like, that kind of stuff.
So you think YouTube's, like, also okay with just, like, the reaction shit that she posts? Like, all that slop that she's been posting onto the platform, they're f***ing cool.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She's making the money.
Well, think of it like this, you know, if YouTube were to side with Jack here, then that would set the precedent, which is supposedly already a rule, saying that, like, you know, there's no relation to their channel and what they do outside of YouTube. If they were to strike down Sniper Wolf, then, like you said, EDP, then there's a spotlight on, like, every other scenario where they just didn't take anything else outside of YouTube into account, and then it just downfall, you know, it's just a waterfall from there. So they're probably just trying to dodge that bullet, you know, in the bud and call it a day.
But they did ban EDP, right?
I know, yeah, but then they also... EDP. Then they also nuked that other channel of the, like, people, like, Critics, like, commenting on him.
They nuked down channels that were covering his sting operation, his vigilante operation.
Yeah, vigilante's been bad for a long time.
But as far as, like, EDP, they actually did kick him off, and they kicked him off for something he did off-platform, right? Like, especially because doxing someone does violate YouTube's terms of service. It doesn't say if you dox someone in a YouTube video, you're violating YouTube.
He's also file, which is a lot different than Sniper Wolf.
Well, remember, Taylor, allegedly. No, well, like, but like, the thing is, even with, like, it's actually interesting because in ADP's case, he was, like, alleged pedophile. Like, he didn't even get, like, charges on him. YouTube just shut him down because it was that blatantly obvious EDP's a pedophile. And then, like, I think if EDP would, like, try to sue us for, like, defamation or something.
They will never sue you for defamation.
Yeah. First off,
EDP, can you imagine going to court for defamation and then you pull up the the cupcake clip?
Oh my god. Actually, you know what? I kind of do want to fucking lock. It'd be fucking hilarious as shit. Have you guys been keeping up with, like, the two Matt situation? Have you guys been seeing what he's been up to lately?
Yeah.
I was following up until a point, and then I was just like, all right, this man.
I had to bleach my eyes when I saw that he, one of his alternative accounts, I believe, tributed me.
I saw
Let's
that, yeah.
Let's go, Muda. You're such a big boy. You're so famous and hot.
Dude, I wanted to fucking, I wanted to die at that moment. Like, when I saw, because I thought, like, I saw a photo of me, and then, like, I saw the reflection of the cum on the fucking phone screen.
Oh.
And at that point, I just, like, wanted Jesus to die. Christ. Like, I was just done with it, dude.
I'm telling you, when your camera started moving, I thought you were like, oh, all right, let me show you. And then you were going to pull out, like, a little cum tribute for Muda.
No, that's for the after show. No.
Tumat is, like, one of those guys where I just have no idea what is, like, some of the most unhinged shit that I've seen on the platform by far. You know, I don't know if you, have you made a video on him yet, Caleb, Tumat?
Yeah, I made a couple, and,
since the last time we talked about it, did you add anything? Or,
cause I know no, you made a no, couple, he's... Okay. I'm trying to get him out here. I'm trying to just, like, communicate with him a little bit, but it's hard to. It's difficult.
I think it's tough given the fact that, like, he, like, Tumat has been pretty open about, like, this weird civil lawsuit that he's been involved in. I don't exactly know what the details are right off the top of my head, but every single day that he's on the internet, he just makes it look so bad. Like, if you were to be his lawyer, dude, I have no idea how they haven't dropped him as a client yet, because he will not shut the fuck up about legal affairs or shitting on the other party that he's getting with. It's just insanity at this moment in time with him.
It is odd.
Yeah, my favorite conversation I ever had with Tumat is he messaged me the word gay. And then I responded in the good way, and he says, epic gay moment!
Huh.
And that was it.
I don't know if he ever, like, switches off the memeing. That's so weird. It's like, he is, like, a perpetual, like... I guess the best way to describe him, it's like fucking Reddit personified, you know? Like, if Reddit, like, if the top board of, if, like, Reddit top slash, like, the top post was, like, an actual human being. Not like a webpage, you know? Like, an actual person that just kept regurgitating that shit every day. He's just, like, a meme-y guy. And, you know, years ago, he was probably one of the most popular, like, YouTubers in that space, right? Like,
yeah, with, like, the Zoom crashing and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, that was, like, huge for him, and I don't know what
happened.
Didn't
we play Among Us with him once, Muda? Didn't that happen? Didn't we play Among Us with him?
I try to, like, drink away the Among Us memory, but probably.
I think that happened, yeah.
No, we did. We did play Among Us on his own server, but this is, like, and even at the time, he was, like, a pretty cool dude, you know? He's kind of loud. I think anytime I've had a DM with Tumat, it's always been, like, just... It's been high energy, you know? Like, in a DM, I'm pretty fucking relaxed. I think all of you guys can pretty much attest to the fact that when I'm DMing, it's a relaxed conversation. But, like, I try to be funny if I can, like, you know, crack a joke every once in a while. But usually when we're talking about serious shit like lawsuits, it's like, dude, you can't be dropping the Baba Booey on me, okay? We're talking about, like, a fucking lawsuit. Like, we're talking about a lawsuit. You can't be dropping the Overwatch Rule 34 had me talking.
Yeah,
not today.
Bad idea, man.
Yeah, I don't know what's going to happen with this court case. I honestly don't think it's going to go too well for him. I think, honestly, this is a guy that has had a career basically, like, the best way I can just say it right now, doing YouTube involves a lot of luck, right? You have to be pretty lucky to get here on this platform and be, like, one of the top 1% of people that can make a living off of this. The fact that he squanders that shit and throws it away is... It actually really pisses me off the more I think about it. Because it's like, how do you get an opportunity like this and just completely fucking squander it, you know?
Like, but it's wild to me. The thing that throws me for a loop with Too Mad is he'll have, like, his crazy Baba Booey schizo energy, and then he'll start suddenly, really interestingly and eloquently debate Hassan about, like, some sort of political situation. You're like, where did this come from? This is the guy that's just there bouncing his titties all stream, and he's having, what is going on?
I have to imagine that when that happens, it's probably like he's talked to like somebody else, like Destiny or something, and they're kind of like back channeling shit like that. It's just his whole situation. It just like really pisses me off because he's had the world sort of given to him, and he just squanders it. Like yesterday, I read this one tweet, and this is a reason why I wanted to talk about Too Mad too a little bit. Was like, I don't know if you saw that one tweet yesterday where it was like, I own her mouth or some shit like that.
Oh my god.
Dude, damn. It's here. Let me see if I can f-ing find it. Actually, yeah,
it's fucking weird, bro.
Like, I actually don't even want to show that f-ing tweet right now because it shows the girl that he's involved with, and that's not like, I just don't want to do that. But anyways, it was like this really dysfunctionally weird tweet where he's just, again, if you were involved in a lawsuit with somebody, right, you would not start tweeting like this, okay?
Muda, no. That would be, if you show me that tweet, that would be maybe the second weirdest tweet I saw today.
What's the first weirdest?
I was delving into a certain VTuber drama, just out of curiosity, and right now the tweet's deleted, but if you Wayback Machine, you could find it. It's a VTuber. I don't exactly know all the details, but I don't even want to say it on stream. She stapled her together.
What? No, hold on, hold on.
And she posted it on Twitter.
How do you seek that out? How do you come across that?
I was researching weird VTuber dramas of sorts, and I stumbled upon it.
How's that something you come back from?
You want to see
like
it?
A virtual staple thing?
Wait,
or is it like
hold on, describe it. Was it like a real stapled pussy or like
no,
a virtual
it's
one?
Like, it's yeah. No, it's real. Real. Like, I don't know how it transpired, but it was like a kind of, oh yeah, ooh, I'm a masochist.
And that's not being a masochist. It's like being, like, neurodivergent.
That's weird.
Just saying, I have the Wayback link for you if you want it.
Not a fan of that.
I don't know if I'm ready to see staple pussy.
Okay.
Like, right,
I think no. I'm good.
Yeah, we're good.
That is insane, though. It's like, yeah. Wait, what was the responses to it? Was she getting like quote tweet? Was she getting like quote ratio?
Yeah, a little bit. She got like 300 likes on the tweet, which was impressive. I don't
dude,
know.
Dude, all that for 300 f***ing likes, man. Holy f***ing shit. Just f***ing kill me. That, like, I'm not even a chick right now, but I feel like my balls completely hurt thinking about that entire f***ing situation right now. God
yeah.
damn.
Yeah.
That
when
is...
I heard about it, I was like, nah, that's not real. But it's
dude,
real.
Some see people will do the weirdest shit on the internet for like uplight for like you know votes on the internet. I mean, shit. Just in this podcast alone, we discussed a guy who literally violated like breaking laws in Japan just to fucking just for YouTube content, dude. We switched to the point where it's like people will do fucking anything to get famous on the internet, and I think with like part of me loves it. Like I love Kick and I love a lot of these streaming services where like they just have like dumbasses. On a daily being stupid, you know, because it's like it's just content every day to like laugh at, but it's also like the internet's never been as wild as it has been now, you know, like
yeah,
this is
it's getting crazier and crazier. It's like I remember when TikTok like was going viral in the beginning and everyone was talking about TikTok and people did that licking ice cream in grocery stores thing, right? You remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Like I remember seeing that and be like, "Wow, that's as bad as it's gonna get." They're actually committing crimes.
Did you forget did you forget like when people kicked open front doors and shit?
Right, like, and then that happened, and then people started stealing shit. Remember that
yeah,
trend?
Yeah,
they were just
doing, like,
stealing
the great
toilets
lick challenges.
And stuff.
Devious licks, man.
Devious licks.
Stealing entire hell. Our co-host here had an entire fucking urinal as a joke for that, but it wasn't a joke for some people. They straight up stole school urinals. Dude, like, that's the wildest shit. It's like, when I was a kid, if I stole something, my parents would figure it out. There's no fucking way that I'm, like, going to school, unfucking, like, tethering a urinal from the wall, bringing that shit home, and nobody's home to, like, fucking question me on it. That, my friends, might have been the wildest trend on there. But even, like, with TikTok, there was, like, the other trends where, like, they had, like, carjackings, like the Kia challenge, where motherfuckers were just, like, stealing cars.
Dude, what is going on? Why are you documenting yourself doing crimes?
Yeah, it's pretty dumb.
I mean, it doesn't make any sense. It's like, is the newer generation this fucking stupid where, like, they think that you can do this and, like, there's no consequences from it at all?
But is it really the newer generation if this guy just uploaded a video? He's in his 20s. He's our age, more or less. This guy that just traveled through Japan for free.
He's how old again?
He's in his 20s, right? He's pretty much our age. Maybe he's 2-3 years younger.
If you're two, three years younger, you're still old enough. Listen, if you're over the age of 20, you're old enough. If you're over the age of, like, 16, you should know that fucking stealing is wrong, okay? I'm pretty sure they ingrained that shit from the start, you know?
Stealing is wrong, and documenting that you are stealing is not only wrong, but it's also stupid.
Yeah, but it's insane because I think there's, like, no consequences attached to it. It's like, now, like, one of the things that I love about, like, this Johnny Somali thing is, like, he will get jail time, right? And I think as much as people, like, think that prison and jail is excessive as what other punishment do you have, right? Like, what can you do? What are you going to let them go
cut
free and keep
hands
making fools? Yeah, but
listen, one guy
there are some countries, Knox, that do that shit, okay? Like, he should go to Saudi Arabia and start f***ing shoplifting. They will chop your hands off there. They don't give a f***. They follow old school laws up in that, you know? But and that's maybe one of the reasons why some streamers don't go to countries like that, because they know that, like, they're fucking psychopaths. But, like, with Japan, they're not going to fuck around. What up, JJ?
These people do not give a shit. I mean, I'm sure you guys talked about this already, about that one guy who was, like, getting up in his face for a prank video and then he got shot.
Mm-hmm. Tanner Mays? I think he is?
He's already making videos again.
No shot, dude. Already.
He just did, like, this air... He got kicked out of an airport just recently.
Okay, send us a clip for this.
Shit, what the fuck?
Yo, aren't you happy that your content is just making fun of superhero comics?
Yeah, I don't have to delve into murder and crime.
I can't wait for the
crime.
First TikToker comic to come out.
Yeah, hey, when's the YouTube drama JJ channel?
The YouTube drama JJ channel?
You can call it Solid SS and just talk about Sniper Wolf.
It's not even like drama. Like, Tanner is, like, hilarious because I cannot believe that he's actually back to making videos. Like, getting kicked out of an airport for what, though? Let me. What's his name again, guys? Tanner... airport prank.
You can't even be mad at him, though. Like, if you get shot in the chest and then you come back to make another prank video, you kind of have to respect it.
Honestly,
you know,
true.
As big an asshole as you are, you got a bullet in your system and you're still going out to make, like, XD moments. Like, alright.
I respect it. I can't believe this is real. Dude, how are these real people?
Dude, is this the video you're talking about?
Yes. Yeah.
There's no
floating
shot, bro.
Detained at the airport. Oh my god.
Dude, there's no fucking... It is the airport. Holy fuck, it is. I can see
what
American
idiot,
Airlines,
dude.
British Airways, Condor. Oh fuck, dude.
What is the production here? He has establishing shots and everything?
Well, I mean, you know, if you're gonna make yourself look like a fucking dumbass...
Dude, look
the
at
internet.
The likes, dislikes on that. Oh, no.
I mean, clearly people just don't understand good content. So he said the baggage claim and shit.
Yeah, for shame.
With people at the baggage. What a fucking douchebag. Dude, this is a man that thinks he's the main character of everything. I fucking think it's great as fuck.
That reminds me of...
Dude, I love this.
You know the video of the guy that traveled through Japan for free? My favorite part of the video was after he got arrested the first time, right, for not having enough money to pay the taxi, he said, "Guys, I was detained by the Japanese authorities for 5 hours, and I didn't even have my phone to film it." And I was like, okay, dude.
Dude, it's what I love so much about this guy is, like, this title, like, I got shot. Because what's so beautiful about this title is it's not clickbait, because we all know he got shot. But just imagine, he gets shot, right? And the first thought that goes through his mind is, am I going to make it? No, not that. It's, bro, just imagine the fucking 1 out of 10 I'm going to get on the creator studio when this gets fucking posted. I fucking love that, dude. You know, part of me wants to hate this guy, but part of me just wants to love him for being this gloriously stupid.
Yeah, it's like, it's impressive in its own way. All these people doing their people things.
So, looking into this video, guy, I can start to see why he got arrested. Is this guy just a Mr. Beast clone?
I don't know where you see that resemblance.
He's a genius.
Dude,
he's kind of like a visionary.
Dude, I traveled around the earth for free.
He's standing on a plane wing. Look at that thumbnail. Oh my god.
I live 7 days in the airport for free.
Okay, but like, dude, you see how, dude? Oh, that's my favorite one. The 100 hours in the world's poorest country.
There's no way. I want to see what the first 5 seconds of the video is gonna be like.
This is the world's poorest country, and there is a lot of bad things said about it. That's why I'm going to spend the next 100 hours
this
here to see with
this the worst poorest country.
They are short poor.
Dude, if I ever make a video about this guy, I'm gonna have to really try not to mimic his accent.
Why? Just mimic it.
Oh my god. Yeah, mimic
this
it.
This is the best poorest country.
You sound like Tommy Wiseau.
What is he? What is his, where is he from?
Let me see where he's
this,
from here.
This...
I went to Africa, unlike MrBeast.
I'm better than MrBeast.
That MrBeast, he's from the United States, dude. He's from your country.
He's from, no he's from Oregon. That's an Oregon accent.
No fucking chance, dude.
So I was wondering if the rumors are true. And after 3 hours, we made it out of there to meet our guy.
Welcome, Burundi. You seem tired.
Yeah.
It was already 5 a.m. in the morning and the sun rose. While being in the car, our guide said something shocking. That
dude.
The average salary of workers in Burundi is...
around $400.
It's $100.
Yeah, it's around $100.
Dude, he's finally discovering third world wages. Jesus. He said something really shocking
it's
to me.
Around $100.
Where do you hold your challenge videos?
Dude, this is why I miss prank channels. Like, I miss the prank channel. You remember the one prank video where it's like going to Mexico with fake Coke and they just had like a back, like, they had their trunk filled with Coca-Cola, but they actually came across the one f-ing border agent that was actually with the cartel? Like, they actually almost got f-ing because of all this. I miss
That's
prank
glorious.
Channels like that where like you had shit like this is the you know how people like complain about MrBeast being like a I guess he's like a charity, like a merchant or something, right? Like he uses charity for advancements. I feel like the actual anger should be given towards this guy. This is like the first 20 seconds of this video is just I went to the world's biggest shithole for 100 hours.
World's poorest country.
Look at all these people. Why their skin so dark?
Oh. Jesus Christ,
I'm pretty sure he has a line like that in one of his videos that I saw.
No way.
Dude, if he has a line like that, my god. We are f***ing being too nice to YouTube.
Maybe I'm mistaken. I remember delving down this rabbit hole when he uploaded that video.
Same.
Like a year ago.
Oh, he's from Cyprus. We're related.
Let's go.
He's a Cypriot.
He's a Cypriot.
That's why you sound so similar.
Yeah, right? Like,
I am from Western Asia.
Dude, oh, I feel like that's no that. Shit, Caleb, because I bet if we looked up Cypriot accents, it still wouldn't be like that.
No.
Cyprus accent is just the British accent.
His name is Fifi. His real name is Fifi Panayoto.
Let's go.
Dude, this
Fifi.
This dude, wait, there's no shot. He's got a GoFundMe for the Burundi people. I didn't even know that. Well, at least he does charity. Like, look at that. GoFundMe.com for it. Well, at least it's better than nothing, dude. Like, Jesus Christ. He's out
I mean,
there
he's,
like
he's obviously trying to do good. It's just a little heavy-handed.
Yeah, like
is
you know,
he though? Is he really trying to do good?
He's trying to do some good along with his you know, normal YouTuber.
All right, let me search for
camera.
Poor in the video here. Let me search for like poor in his shit.
In the transcript.
No, I'm looking for. I'm looking
hanging
for
out
here.
With poor people today.
I spent $20,000 in the world's poorest
just
country.
Just like you can eat, but they're poor.
They're like me, but no money.
Today I went to a village that make less than I do. Everybody, like, what the f***, bro? What is it? Spend $20,000? I need to see this short. This is crazy.
If you had $20,000 to spend in the world's poorest...
His voice doesn't even match his mouth.
$20,000. What is... Like, YouTube sucks, bro. Why is this a f***ing... It's crazy that I'm a YouTuber. I would f***ing... Jesus Christ.
How will you spend it? after making a YouTube video in Burundi in 2022 and seeing how much the people need help there, we asked our subscribers to donate money, and after a couple of months we collected 10,000 from you, and I donated.
How much did you donate,
10,000?
Fat Why does fucking he, look- he donated the exposure. He got some subscribers for that village.
Why does he look like a younger Fred Armisen?
He really does. He really does.
A lot of ideas on how to spend it.
Wait, he's going to spend it now? Why didn't he just give it to them?
We're going to seriously consider what you guys want in the most.
I wonder if he's from East or West Cyprus.
The most liked comment is what we're going to spend it on? Oh my god, you're joking me.
He didn't say he's going to spend it on it. He's going to seriously consider it.
Oh my god, dude.
Build a water well so that people can gather fresh, clean mineral water. Oh, that's awesome.
He will seriously consider that.
We're gonna consider that shit. What is a tax write-off we get?
And then he's gonna say, you know, I like that idea. However, I was thinking of making a rink where Burundi people could fight each other, and the winner.
What if I give brand new Honda Civic to village chief?
That's my. What if I give them many hot dogs?
Wait, what is this? Day 16 of trying to hug Elon Musk? There's no fucking way this is a real video. Dude, there's no way this is a real video. Day 16 of trying to hug Elon Musk. What? Is this a thing?
Day 16 of trying to hug Elon Musk.
Dude, I swear to God, if this is... Holy shit, dude.
Oh my God.
Look at this.
He is such a simp.
I'm gonna make a new fucking channel where it's like day one of trying to like hug Caleb Villas. Look at dude, day 37. No shit. Let me see this.
Hello, sir. A security call. They talked to me and they said that right now you're not on private property, right? You're on public property. It's not breaking any laws. They just told me that they don't want you inside the actual Twitter HQ building here. And if you do enter the building, they will.
Yo, why are we so mad at Sniper Wolf?
What the fuck
is wrong with us? Wait, because why are we so mad at her? This guy has been doing this for a month straight to Elon.
Okay, but he's doxing Twitter HQ. It's not like, you know.
Stranger harassing Indian policeman. Dude, what the f? Dude, I'm with Caleb.
You don't see Mr. Beast making these videos.
No. I'm making a video on this guy for sure.
This is awesome.
I'm going on a deep dive. Deep dive.
Dude, me too.
My brother.
Me too. We should work together on this.
I tried the five most dangerous jobs. What is he doing to that tree?
I met America's worst mom. Okay, let's see this one.
New York City to meet the worst mom in the planet.
Count to you.
He traveled to New York to find the worst mom. Dude, whoever raised him is high on that list for contenders.
He makes his videos the same way that Family Guy makes theirs in the South Park episode. There's no way you come up with, I'm going to meet America's worst mom off the top of your head. There's no way. Those aren't real thoughts.
It. Remember the time I went America's worst mom in New York?
You married her daughter? Lost her kids? Stole from them? I don't know.
I'm here about to meet her now. I'm stressed.
This is the worst mom in the world.
Tell me, why they say that you're the worst mom in the world?
It's because I let my 9-year-old ride the subway by himself.
That's it?
That's it. That's it. It's so easy.
I came here not because you are the worst mom in the world, because I think you are the best mom in the world. I want you to give an advice to parents out there.
Dude,
what?
I hate
what is that twist?
This video does not exist. This is not real.
This is a real fucking video.
What?
Can we look at their hands and just make sure they're like not blurred out? Like, this
wait,
is real.
Hold on. We need to do the AI check on this.
Because you are the worst mom in the world. Because I think you are the best mom in the world. I want you to give an advice
best
to parents.
Best mom in the world.
I love how like you have to do the emojis all the time with these because that's what attracts the fucking embryo.
He's so Greek.
No, but dude,
he's such a Greek person.
That story. Did you hear that story? I'm gonna go meet the worst mom.
Mom in the world.
You're the worst mom. Why are you the worst mom? Because I let my kid ride the subway at 9 alone. You're not the worst. You're the
best.
Tell people around the world.
We had
planet?
The we had the seven passenger situation. I thought he was going to go talk about that, not some random chick in New York City.
I like to imagine that he went there telling her that he's going to, like, ask her questions and then didn't tell her at all what was going to happen and then just turned the camera and pointed right in her face. You are the worst mom in the world. Why?
Why, well, yes, I am.
This is my favorite. This is... I almost got arrested in China. All right, boys, let's see how he got arrested.
Oh, my God, dude.
I will vlog my first time going to China. This is my hotel in China. And let's go down the streets. So I've been here for 4 days and I was just bored to make this video, but I will show you my favorite stuff.
Breaking into their transit and getting Dude, away with it.
I love his performance.
I walk his into the first shop I found, and you can get every vegetable you want only for $4. And I give it to them.
Damn.
Thank you.
Chinese food is the best.
Another thing that I wanted to try is foot massage. I went inside the foot massage place, and a man started undressing me instantly.
That's pretty good. That's pretty funny, bro.
That's awesome.
He knows what he's doing. Does he even mean to be funny?
He knows what he's doing, for sure.
He's Greek. They're known for that. They're happy, man. They're happy people down there.
I went to a massage parlor and immediately started...
Cypriot.
I went to China and a man started undressing me immediately.
After the foot massage was done, I went outside to tell you something crazy that happened. So the last couple of days, I made a very good friend here in China, and I asked her, what do you think about the president? And she said, I'm not allowed to talk about this in public.
Dude, he's gonna go
that
to jail.
That was the whole video!
Wait, that's where he almost got arrested.
He almost got arrested because they almost talked about the president in public.
He almost heard the words Winnie the f***ing Pooh, dude. What the f- I finally met Elon Musk. Oh boy, it's alright, this is the last one for him, but then I'm gonna definitely deep dive this.
Us was coming from this direction and I was going to this direction. And
dude, this is just a diary, a stalking diary.
And when he's
you're right, it's like a stalking vlog.
Yeah, it really is. This is
the
weird.
Whole thing, it's just a diary of like on Wednesday I stalked like, Elon Musk but got stopped by his security.
It's totally fine to stalk people as long as people are Elon Musk and Mr. Beast, and if you're a YouTuber.
Sure.
That's all it is. He's like literally outside the San Fran office. If I was Elon Musk, I would be fucking scared.
He saw me and we locked eyes, started moving very fast to the other thing.
Saw him and started booking it.
And this is day 55 of me trying to give him a hug. And when he saw me and we locked eyes, he started moving very fast to the other thing.
Yeah. The other direction.
He saw him and ran away.
And I was disappointed because my favorite person in the world and he avoids me. Not the coolest feeling. After Elon left, I spoke with his bodyguard and I told him I'm sorry that I disturbed his day. On day 56, someone came and offered me...
That bodyguard's like, no, I'm totally cool you exist. I'm the only reason I got this job.
To live for free in his apartment, which is next to Twitter. But more on that tomorrow.
He just doxed him! He just doxed the man! He just found his apartment and posted his apartment online.
Yeah, this is like somebody gave him like a free place to stay.
This is his private apartment!
What the f***, dude?
He just followed the guy home and took a picture of his apartment?
Dude, Elon Musk bodyguard talked. No way.
Finally.
Elon Musk bodyguard came and told me that they respect what I'm doing. That I
yeah, right. Bull my
fucking
asshole.
Shit. Ooh, I don't believe that at all.
Down outside his company for 47 days without leaving, just to give him a hug. But he said that they can't allow this to happen because if he hugs me, then hundreds of people will come outside Twitter and ask
him for stuff.
This is not the good news. But failure is not an option.
Dude, just like, this is the personification of like the worst of Twitter. Look at his shirt, bro. He's still riding the Dogecoin. Come on.
I thought this was like spaced out over time. Like, he would just like
find instances. Dude, look at the YouTube shorts. 3.3 million.
He just camped out there.
He was just there that entire time.
Dude. Is that the most popular one? The one that he met him allegedly and they locked eyes and he ran away?
No,
I'm hugging the most popular guy in the world.
No, right here. I hugged the world's top 100 celebrities. I shook the top 100 YouTubers' hands.
Go to the 100 celebrities and go to number one. Who's the top? Who's the top one?
Number one celebrity?
My goal is to hug the top 100 celebrities in the entire planet.
All right, let's see. Who's number one?
So far, he showed pointing to the globe.
So far, he showed Messi and f***ing Elon Musk.
Text. They said, come now to get the hug. It's time to meet my...
this is just doing booty calls for rich people.
Ladies and gentlemen,
No way. He actually did it.
Dude, stalking works, bro.
Dude, this whole
episode has just been... He's like worried.
Well, the last 3 months, I've been staying outside in the streets, making videos and all this stuff. And I want to say...
Dude, that realization in his head that he's kind of fucking, like, unhinged, even to him, is crazy.
Thank you to all the people that convince you. The kids in the World Cup, all the people.
Yeah, like, so just that, the kids could, they could ask for anything for themselves. Like, they asked if I could hug you. I was like, well, okay.
I love your communication because you are not very easy to articulate things.
You are not saying that to him.
Dude, he's so Greek.
This
he
is
so Greek, it's not even funny.
The kettle black thing I've ever seen in my
very
life.
Very hard to understand.
You are a very dumb guy.
This is the most awkward
you,
ass
you say
I've
things
ever
very
seen.
Simple, but you're
this
a weird
guy. This guy is just influencer Borat.
he truly is. He's Greek Borat.
Dude, I want to screenshot this and just make it my Twitter profile picture.
Dude, you know there are like three people behind the camera with guns.
But you are this kind of weird guy, which is so cool to meet you in person.
You're welcome.
Okay. It's time for the hug.
There's no
okay.
way. Oh my
are
god.
Ready?
Finally,
I mean,
let's go.
You seem pretty good at hugging, so this must be like a hell of a good hug or something. I don't know.
Damn, he's like working ready for this.
That's so weird, bro.
Oh my god. Thank you guys for watching. I love you. Goodbye. We did it.
And now I will.
He came in his pants.
Bro.
Oh my god.
Wow, what a
dude.
Fucking weirdo. Jesus
dude.
Christ.
Dude, oh wait,
hello.
Hold on. You get the squeakly app. What the f***, dude? I got handcuffed to 100 strangers.
Go back to that video. See what he films with. He has a commission link for what he films with. Click on it. See if he's actually being honest.
Let me see.
Wait, where's the?
You have to go through the ad. I think.
Wrong one.
Wrong one.
Where do I
wrong
go
video.
To?
I think
you have to play
video.
Through the ad.
Oh,
it's the top 100 celebrities video,
anyways.
Got a popular.
You're right. Sorry. Top 100 celebrities.
And then click the Amazon link, yeah. Let's see if a lot of people, what they'll do is they'll lie. They'll say, this is what I used to film with, and then it's like much cheaper, so people actually buy it.
I don't think this is what he's filming with.
We can't see
it. Doesn't,
it. What is it?
It doesn't show.
Hold on. Let me
we can't see it.
The step.
Oh, yeah. See, that's definitely not what he's filming with. But it's cheap. It's cheap, so people will buy it. So he gets commission on it.
Damn.
That's smart.
A lot of people do that. It's. I don't know if it's like... I don't know if that's allowed. Are you allowed to do that? Is that illegal? Is that like a just lying
well,
people,
I mean, like,
manipulating
them? I think that's also under I don't think you can do that under the TOS. But I also, Caleb, don't think that you can stalk Elon Musk for 45 days until he's forced to
that's
give you a
point,
hug.
Muda. That's a good point, Muda. I want to bring something up. Are you guys how old are you, Muda?
I'm 29.
Okay. How old are you, Nux?
27.
What about you, JJ?
24.
Okay. When's your birthday, Nux?
February 9th.
Okay, so you're old. So I'm younger than y'all. I'm only by a little bit. Only by 6 months. I'm 27 as well. Dude, you guys have gray hair?
I do not.
I do.
Dude. You do have gray hair? How much?
Jen found like one or two pieces on me.
Dude, you guys gotta tell me, am I gonna die?
I think so.
Because look how much f***ing gray hair I have.
Bro, this is what happens when you use
look
the face app to make yourself look f***ing old.
Look at that.
Damn.
My hair is apparently 10% gray.
Do you have a will?
I do.
Just making sure.
I'm 27 my hair is 10% gray and I'm 27 years old. That cannot be normal.
Because,
listen,
because
I think it's
stressed.
Different for different people, bro. Don't worry about it.
I have never met a 27-year-old. Also, I'm only 27. I just turned 27. And
happy birthday.
It was in August. No worries. September, I guess. Or early. Whatever. Doesn't matter. Thank you. Am I dying, guys? Am I going to be all right?
I think you're going to be fine. As long as you avoid months like August where you prophesize your death, you should be just fine.
Dude, look at how many gray hairs I have.
The chances of you dying are much bigger than the chances of you just living.
I almost feel like that may be a genetic thing almost. I don't know.
Dude, if I have a fucking... If I'm still doing commentary YouTube in like 4 years and I have a totally gray head of hair, that would suck. People are going to be like, this guy's 40. And I'm not. I'm only 27. I just turned 27.
Hey, look, man, I would appreciate that. I would think that's pretty fucking cool. You should own the silver hair, dude.
The candy, it aged me very quickly, to be honest.
I mean, honestly, that's what it does. Either gives you diabetes or fucked up other shit.
Yeah, well, dealing with all the stress and shit.
Well, before we end this show, I want to watch one more video by Phidias together because he is just a treasure trove.
Can I just point out legend. Real quick, his thumbnails? I love he sees Mr. Beast and he's like, if I just go like 20 times beyond that, these will do really well. Mr. Beast has like an open mouth smile. He has sticks in his eyes.
Boys, I wanted to show you this video
so
right here.
Bro.
Homeless in the most dangerous place in America.
Wow. Oh my God. That is so funny.
Every thumbnail is a saw trap.
Oh, absolutely.
For a second, I thought that was him.
No, this is somehow. All right, boys, prepare.
I am going to spend the next 3 days homeless in Los Angeles with the last day being the most dangerous street, Skid Row.
This is so fucking stupid.
It's wild.
I have seen Skid Row in person, and I do not remember there being a big piece of graffiti that says Skid Row City Limits in Los Angeles. I just want to put that out for the people
interesting.
Watching.
Interesting.
LA's most troubled places. Skid Row. Gang members.
He actually stabbed a man in the head with an ice pick.
Firstly, I came to this park to make some new homeless people friends. Oh.
Dude, that is awesome.
Oh my
this
god.
Guy.
Dude. I came to this park to make some new homeless friends.
While I was exploring the park, one non-profit organization came to give food to the homeless people.
And we focus on providing mutual aid.
Dude, this poor girl thinks she's on like some news or like some documentary.
Little does she know, she's fucking the subject of a Greek dude who loves Mr. Beast, who's exploiting the homeless.
She like fucked off, looked up his channel, was like, oh my god, he stalks Elon, what the
so much variety of stuff.
It's time for the big basketball game.
So much variety of stuff.
11, 10. Oh, you are going to sleep in your tent and I will sleep in my couch
tonight.
Oh my god, it's so bad!
Oh,
it's
what did
so
he say?
Awful!
What did he say?
He's like, no,
you're
going
to sleep in your
pants
and I'm
going
to sleep in my
couch.
Just listen, he loses the game to this, I guess, homeless guy.
11, 10. Oh, you are going to sleep in your tent and I will sleep in my couch.
He's like, you might have won the basketball game.
Yeah, he's pissed off.
No, dude, except meanwhile, that guy actually is homeless and lives in a tent. And this guy is making millions and millions on YouTube, just kind of...
The sun is going down tomorrow.
There's no way you're sleeping in that park.
Walmart to see some people, but they sleep inside the
house. Oh my god.
He's like, holy people shit.
People do
that
to look
this?
For them? He's looking for homeless people like you look for Pokemon, alright?
Actually, there's no like left or right of this. He's just banking off the homeless people.
Like, this guy's like reverse American. He's like an American.
Damn.
He's in like an American tourist, how American tourists would do stuff in other countries. He's just doing that kind of everywhere. But he's Greek.
I don't do a good job of this is Santa Monica Pier toilet.
Dude, is he filming in the bathroom?
That's actually illegal.
What the?
I feel very thirsty and I want to jump inside the ocean to clean my body and I will do this now.
You're not cleaning your body in the Santa Monica Pier, my man.
I enjoyed the ocean. So guys, I will try to explain you who I am in 10 seconds.
So you know this guy Elon Musk? Yeah, I'm like his biggest
I'm his biggest stalker.
I am happy, disciplined, I'm not organized, a bit boring, I work all time, and that's it about me. good. Yeah. Thank you for listening. Have a great
these
day.
Poor guys.
I wanted you to know some stuff about me. That's why I did it.
Sun is going down and I'm going to marry.
What the f- is this?
This might be a test tube baby.
This he's is so
holding,
funny.
He, this dude, he's going around, he's holding homeless people hostages listening to his terrible life stories.
How is he like? I love this guy so much.
Dude, this is Daniel. He sleeps in the car.
And he sleeps in his car.
This is Daniel.
Poor
and
Daniel.
He's poor. Let us
what
look at
Daniel
his house.
What did Daniel do to be in a Phidias video?
He needs to have like a travel bag with like toothbrushes, socks, underwear, extra clothes.
This is your bed for the night.
That's my bed.
Do you feel safe during the night?
It depends where you're at. I'm fortunate to have a car. Like, I'm very fortunate. A lot of people don't have a car. You gotta learn how to do more with less. You gotta stay positive, man. You gotta work with what you got.
He goes in for the hug. It's like, you know,
I'm going to hug you now.
I will hug you to make myself look like less psychopath.
Dude, he's honestly like one of the. This is the wildest thing. He's now he's like he out here sleeping in the house here. Hold on.
Here tonight, I always wanted to sleep inside a kid playground. So this
you did?
My bed for the night. I stole this from the
I always wanted to sleep inside the kid.
Like, wait.
What? Oh my god!
He stole that?
He stole it from another homeless guy!
No, he did not.
That poor guy is sleeping!
Oh my god.
Dude, that was weird.
Oh my god.
I didn't expect any of this.
Because I'm very cold. One person walked in the park. Started shouting to me. I'm a bit afraid now to sleep here with that guy. I'm not gonna lie.
I might go back to my mansion.
Dude, he is the yin to Mr. Beast's yang.
Worst case scenario.
Mr. Beast gives, he takes.
I don't care about him. I'm so tired that I want to sleep at night. Good morning. It's Skid Row Day.
Now it's time to go to the Mecca of poverty.
Dude, I cannot believe I can't believe he stole a mattress from another homeless person.
Be very careful who you talk to. Thank you for the food.
Dude, there's no f***ing shot. There's no shot that happened. Look at this. He literally took food from that guy. Like, what the f***?
This is so twisted.
You are good, but you cannot fall. How old are you, sir? I am 21. So I'm trying to keep low profile so people don't understand what I'm
doing. Dude.
What's the scariest thing that you saw here?
Oh, mask.
How many years you are here?
49.
Oh my god, just casually.
I live here.
You like this place?
Yeah, I like this place.
Do you have any advice for me that I will sleep here?
Just keep quiet and try and get along with whoever you meet on the street.
This car just stopped by. He dropped some clothes. They gave me as well a hat. No, this is my...
He's taking the hats from these poor people. Like,
Dude, he's like actually accosting the fucking homeless there.
This is so wrong, bro. Dude, I still can't believe he stole a mattress from like a homeless person. Like, for his content. That, for me, that's the worst. Then literally went and stole a mattress from a homeless person.
Oh, dude.
That is awesome. Dude, what a legend.
This is
wait,
like...
does he end the video saying, like, I have no money to give them, but subscribe?
Well, we'll see.
It's been successfully the night on Skid Row. Oops. I might not have 10,000 to give you to subscribe like Mr. Beast, but I put all my effort and creativity in these YouTube videos. And now I have to live the street by subscribe.
Dude, that is so brilliant. I actually love this, man.
We are
in the wrong market, boys. All of us.
Yeah, 100%. We gotta just sleep in Skid Row.
That's some of the most dystopian shit I think I've ever seen.
Dude, the fact that he went... Dude, he
and
loses
like,
the basketball.
It's super rewarded by the platform. Like, it, the man is so successful.
It is just... He is remarkably socially inept. He has no awareness, social awareness whatsoever.
And his videos are also like 99% likes until like the commentary people just get a hold of it. Right, like
I,
so strange.
Read this comment. This is. I feel like this is exactly who we think we are. Read this one.
Phidias, seeing a person crying for their life. Also, Phidias, this is one of the most beautiful experiences of my life.
That's literally it, dude. Holy man, this comment section just eats that shit up. Like, my God. It's actually so wild. It's the fact that...
Go back up.
I felt my heart... Hold on. There are so many funny comments.
You actually make us feel things.
I felt my heart thumping to be fast while watching Skid Row Day.
Dude, that is so
funny. It's
like
very brave from you. Yeah, right. Almost as brave as, you know, donating to them, I guess.
Oh, shit.
What?
I don't get why you have only 33,000 subscribers. You're literally the funniest, bravest, nicest, and coolest man in history.
Oh my God.
I love seeing you meet and talk to so many humans in this.
Oh my God.
Dude, I just, like, you know when I think months ago I was telling you, it's like, what if I made, like, a Mr. Evil Beast where I just did f***ed up shit but gave people money? This guy stole from the homeless, like, on camera. Like, unashamedly. He loses a basketball game and he says, now you're going to sleep on street and I'm going to sleep on my couch. F***ing insanity, dude. I love this man. Like,
my favorite part is he's in control of what we see. He doesn't have to admit that he stole a f***ing mattress. He could have just used it.
Stealing a mattress and filming a public toilet.
You know what, Caleb? We really should deep dive this. We should talk later today about this guy, like, deep research him. Because here's the thing. Everyone's looking at him right now because of his Japan thing. But they have no f***ing idea about the Elon Musk stalking and the homeless people in Skid Row. Forget Japan. That's, like, the lightest thing in the world. Nothing is as dystopian as what we've just seen. Holy
This guy's a legend.
He flew under the radar, but also built this massive audience at the same time.
We don't hear you. Sorry, we didn't hear you.
I lagged out.
Yeah. You were saying?
I was saying, he's so strange because he somehow flew under the radar and gained this major audience at the same time.
You know the thing is, why? It's because there's so many Mr. Beast clones. I feel like if we just looked at every Mr. Beast clone the way that we look now for more than 10 minutes, we could find some really fucked up shit hidden underneath. But, yeah. Anyways, I think today's been a pretty good episode, honestly. I'm so glad we looked into Phidias. That was some of the most top-tier fun we've had in a while.
Yeah, but, I like Phidias.
He's my favorite.
I approve.
Phidias. Phidias. Nice. Dude, I want to sleep one day in the most homeless ghetto with him.
Today I'm pretending to be homeless. Me when I was 8 and I got mad at my parents. I wanted to run away.
I just love how he, like, goes up to these people's, like, their personal life. It's like, look at him. He's got this house in his car. It's beautiful. This is your bed. It's like, he does not care.
I'm going to steal his bed tonight.
I'm very sleepy.
But, ladies
this
and gentlemen,
kind homeless man gave me his food. Very nice of him.
Well, Nux, you want to take us out?
Thank you all so much for being here. It was a pleasure. Me, Muda, and Caleb, like every week, except for most of them when one of us can't make it. And for the first time, the wonderful man himself, king of the bottom text, Solid JJ. Anything Thanks you want to plug out there, homie?
Just watch more Phidias.
Watch more Phidias!
You know what? At the end of the day, Phidias is a shining example of, like, following your dreams. He got to hug Elon Musk. Sure, it took 50 days of stalking him, kind of illegally, but at least he fucking did it, dude. God bless. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, we are out.